So, my dear friends, this is a question which is to be evaluated, a very special question of limit. And to evaluate this question, we need to use this limit formula. Limit extends to a, x to the power n minus a to the power n upon x minus a, and whose value is n into a to the power n minus 1, where n belongs to what? Where n is a real number. N is a real number. So to apply that formula, we need to have in denominator. What we need to have in denominator? We need to have in denominator this minus this. So let's see how it can be created here. Limit x tends to a. This numerator is x plus 3 to the power 7 by 3 minus a plus 3 to the power 7 by 3. And we can divide this numerator by x minus a, and in the same way denominator by x minus a. X minus a. So let's see. Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. We can divide both numerator and denominator by x minus a. So we have divided both numerator and denominator by x minus a. But in denominator, we need to have x minus a. Suppose if I am saying that it is x and this is a, it means numerator should have in denominator this minus this. Can this be made? Yes, this can be. How? By adding 3 and subtracting 3 here. If I add and subtract 3, then it will be looking like that. Okay, so let's move ahead now and try to write in that way. Limit x tends to a, this x plus 3 to the power 7 by 3 minus a plus 3 to the power 7 by 3 whole upon in denominator, we can have x plus 3 minus a plus 3. You can see these two, a 3 minus 3. This is minus plus minus minus 3. So 3 and minus 3 will cancel each other. In denominator, what we can have in denominator? Let's see. In denominator, we can have x plus 1 to the power 4 by 3 minus a plus 1 to the power 4 by 3, bracket close, upon x plus 1 minus a plus 1 we need. Why? Because in denominator we have x plus 1 instead of that x and a plus 1 instead of that a. So, and what about this limit? So I can separate limit. How can I separate limits of numerator and denominator? Because we have a theorem, a result in limit, a very important result, that limit x tends to a f of x upon g of x is equal to limit x tends to a f of x upon limit x tends to a g of x. But g of a should not be what? G of a should not be 0. If g of a is 0, then of course you can understand that in denominator if it is 0, then this result will not be applicable. So we can separate limits of numerator and denominator both. So we have separated limits. Now everything is looking like this. Instead of x, we have x plus 3. Instead of a, we have a plus 3. And power is 7 by 3 instead of n. So in numerator, everything is looking like that. So we can apply that standard result in this case. And therefore, the numerator becomes 7 by 3 a plus 3 to the power 7 by 3 minus 1. Now we shall calculate it, and in denominator it is 4 by 3 a plus 1 to the power 4 by 3 minus 1. 7 by 3, 4 by 3, 3, 3 can be cancelled, and now limit should not be used because we have substituted its value, and now the ultimate result is 7 by 4 a plus 3 to the power. This is 7 by 3 minus 1 is what? It is 4 by 3, and in denominator you can see it is a plus 1 to the power 1 by 3. So both cannot be clubbed because both are having basis same, powers different, basis different and powers different. But if you find any option using some manipulation in the answer, then it is up to the answers. So you can calculate as per the options. For example, this I can write 7 by 4 a plus 3 whole to the power 4 upon a plus 1 whole to the power 1 by 3. So I can write like this 1 by 3, or in some, or sometimes this may be written like this. So keep this thing in mind, cube root of this. And when we use cube root, this 1 by 3 power will not be there. So it can be written like this. So you can find as per your options. So this is the answer of the given question which we have discussed. Hope you would have enjoyed the solution. So I request you to like, share and subscribe my channel. And it is not my channel, of course, it is your channel. So I need your best wishes for that purpose. And let's see this, if you know L-Hospital rule, L-Hospital or L-Hopital, sometimes we say L-Hospital or L-Hopital rule. If you know that result, then it can be used directly for this kind of limit. Limit extends to a x plus 3 to the power 7 by 3 minus a plus 3 to the power 7 by 3 upon x plus 1 whole to the power 4 by 3 minus a plus 1 whole to the power 4 by 3. If you know that result, then if you know this L-Hopital rule, L-Hopital rule, what does it say? It says if numerator is 0 and denominator is 0, after putting limit, then numerator can be differentiated separately and denominator can be differentiated separately with respect to what? With respect to x. So if I put x is equal to a plus 3 whole to the power 7 by 3 minus a plus 3 whole to the power 7 by 3. So it is what? A minus a, same thing minus same thing 0. And similarly, if I put x is equal to a in denominator, these two will be same and therefore denominator will be 0. So numerator and denominator both are 0. Therefore, the result can be applied, means this rule can be applied here. And what does it say? It says that numerator can be differentiated separately and denominator can be differentiated separately. With respect to what? With respect to this limit, with respect to x. So differentiation of this will be 7 by 3 x plus 3 whole to the power 7 by 3 minus 1. 7 by 3 minus 1 is 4 by 3 without wasting time. And and minus, derivative of this being a constant will be 0. And similarly in denominator, 4 by 3 x plus 1 to the power 1 by 3 minus, derivative of that is 0. And what limit is? So limit x tends to a will remain here, and at the last we shall put instead of x a. So here I'll put x is equal to a and x is equal to a. So you can realize that the answers are same in earlier solution and in after using L-Hospital rule, answers are same. But if you are in class 11, so you cannot apply L-Hospital rule or L-Hopital rule. But if you are appearing for an objective examination, then of course you may use this result. We will be making a different video for L-Hopital rule. Some other